What is up, people? Welcome to this video in which I'm going to tell you how to be a game dev in 2023. You're going to learn about the different roles of game dev, and you're going to learn the practical methodology, a step-by-step approach by which you can become a game developer this year. Whether you want to join a studio in India, whether you want to work abroad in the AAA game industry, or you want to start your own game studio, watch till the end and you will learn all of this in a practical, straightforward manner. So let's go. So my name is Rahul Sehgal. I'm the founder of Game2Maker, India's number one game school, and also the only official partner of the government of India for game development training. So make sure that you follow me on Instagram and LinkedIn as well. And also make sure you join the Game2Maker Discord server. We keep having lots of free events for you guys so that you can actually learn about game development and get the fastest path for yourself to becoming game developers. All the links are in the description of this video. All right, let's get started. Now, firstly and most importantly, remember, you need to understand what the different game development roles are. There is a lot of confusion among people who are not from the game industry because they don't know what is game design, they don't know what is game art, they don't know what is game programming, and they're very, very confused about level design, environment art. And if that is your case, I recommend watching all these videos of mine on my channel in which I'm talking about all the different roles, such as what exactly is game design, what exactly is game art, what exactly is game programming. So once you've understand what the different roles in game development are, you'll have a much, much better idea of what role is best for you. Also, don't worry about which role gives the highest salary, what is in demand, etc. All the roles in game development are in demand in India right now. What matters is your aptitude, what you are good at. Don't try and become a programmer if your tendency, your aptitude is to be an artist, right? You can earn really well, you can do really well. If you want to be a game artist, don't try and do something else. Don't try to wear somebody else's shoes. Concentrate on what is good for you. Another very, very important thing you have to understand is that game development learning is very, very practical. It's not like going to college to learn engineering or learning medicine, that you go to a college, you have some professors that teach you some stuff, you have to mug it up, you have to write down a piece of paper, you have to pass an exam, you get a passing exam, and a company hires you on the basis of that score. Game development is not like that. It is very, very practical. The only way to learn how to make video games is to actually make them. You have to do the work. You actually have to build game development skills like design and art and programming. And once you build these skills, you should be able to showcase it to the companies. You should be able to build a portfolio online, which then you can showcase to companies, and then companies will call you for an interview. They'll check your skills and then you will get a job. So it's not based on degree. It's not based on qualification. You can go to the nicest, most expensive game school in the world, and you will not even get a job as an intern game designer if you don't have those skills. So once again, practicality matters in game development, and not degree, and not definitely not your education qualification. So the next big thing that people ask me is, if I want to get a job, they're asking for experience. But how do you get experience as a game developer if I'm not getting a job? It's kind of like a chicken and egg situation, right? And I'll give you the answer to that. You need to work by yourself on game projects. You need to build a portfolio. You need to build those skills, right? So you can actually become a game developer by yourself. You can download Unity. It doesn't cost any money. You can actually download Unreal. You can build these games. You can build games. And then on the basis of the games you have built, it counts as actual experience. And this experience, then you can present to the game company. They'll say, all right, this person has actually built a game. But there are a few points which you have to be very, very careful about. And I will tell you these points at the end of the video. All right, the next thing I want to clarify is, a lot of people say, sir, which is the best college to go? Where do I go if I want to learn game development in India? And the answer to that is that there is no good game development college in India. Trust me, I've been in the educational system for many, many years in India, which is why I started Gamer to Maker as an alternate to bad colleges that just take your money and take 4 lakh, 5 lakh rupees, and in the end, you don't get any result. For gamart, for game design, for game programming, I'm so sorry to say there is no good game college in India. All the good game colleges are abroad, but they are very, very expensive. You can even check out this video of mine in which I'm talking about the best game colleges in the world, and you will realize they all cost at least 1 to 2 crore rupees to go. Even after that, there is no guarantee that you're going to get a job after going to these colleges. Lastly, remember that making small projects by watching YouTube videos and Udemy will probably not work, because remember that everybody is watching these, right? Everyone's watching these, making Flappy Bird clones, making small a video, making small games and putting them up on their portfolio. This does not work. What you need is a group project in which several people get together. Someone is working as designer, somebody's working as artist, somebody's working as designer. You need to work in a team and build good, more complex projects and then present it to companies, and then companies will be able to hire you, and then they will be able to check you, and that's how you become a proper professional game dev. Right. Next, always remember that network is very, very important. 70% of the jobs in the game industry are not seen outside. You don't see them on LinkedIn, you don't see them on job sites, etc., because they are all hired due to network, because somebody in the company, somebody in the studio says, okay, I need somebody, I'm going to reach out to my friend or my colleague or somebody, and they recommend somebody, and that job posting never even goes out on the internet. So remember, you need to have a very, very strong network to get a job in the game industry. Now, if you're wondering, because this is a problem, right? If you're wondering how you're going to do this, how you're going to build a game, how you're going to find a team, how you're going to learn all these skills, make sure you check out gamertomaker.com. Gamertomaker.com is India's number one online game development school. We are actually accredited by the government of India. We have the stamp of the government of India for our programs, and please make sure you check them out. And if you have any questions, just ping me directly, just write a comment, you know, send me a message on Instagram, check us out on our website. Thank you so much. Let's go.